afternoon, Ms. Gong, my fellow classmates. Today I will be presenting with my colleagues, Xincheng, Kumar, Vivian, and Nathan, on our business proposal for Maxis. My part is the business strategy analyst, and I will be talking on what Maxis's current competitive advantages are and how we recommend that they proceed in such a way that they have a profitable strategy. The problem statement is as such. The company has failed to meet customer and shareholder expectations, leading to a market share loss of 7%, which is equivalent to 200,000 subscribers. The consumer sentiment of Maxis continues depreciating, and they are unable to provide value for the fees that they are charging, which are competitively higher than their competitors. The objectives for my business proposal are to construct a business plan that will recover Maxis's market share by 10% before 2020 and improve organizational performance. Also, I would like to create additional value in Maxis's products and services, and then determine how Maxis can improve its operations so that they are more efficient and they have more efficacy. I would also like to determine how the company can create a more effective marketing strategy that engages its consumers. Next, I would like to determine how Maxis can optimize expenditure so that they can have better uses of their resources, as well as determine how Maxis's human assets can be organized and trained for better delivery of services. I have conducted a PESTEL analysis as well as a Porter's Five Forces analysis to determine what are the factors that control Maxis's competitive advantages. Political-wise, the government-controlled TM continues to dominate the market, because they are a government-controlled entity, so they have more access to contracts and they have a priority basis for their services and such. Celcom, one of Maxis's main competitors, is also under TM or the government, and so they have a very high competitive advantage, and also they are much cheaper compared to Maxis. In February 2016, the Prime Minister also announced a spectrum reallocation for the 4G networks, and so this might have affected Maxis's profitability as well, because the lower frequency bandwidths enable telcos to expand their coverage. And so it is something that is highly contentious among the three main telcos, because they all want the more profitable 1800 megahertz spectrum. Economically, Malaysia, according to the World Bank, has an economic growth slowdown, and so the people are not very open towards higher spending, which is a problem and also one of the reasons why Maxis is losing its subscribers, because their fees are higher than other telcos. Socially, 71% of Malaysians own a smartphone, and so there is a lot of room for expansion business-wise, because there are many other areas to penetrate the market. Technologically, Google has been expanding its 1 GB fiber optic connection, which would put it in direct competition with Maxis's home fiber service if it is extended into Malaysia. The availability of such technology also shows that Maxis's maximum limit speed of 100 MB per second is highly unattractive. Environmentally, Malaysia has a problem expanding its coverage and network because of the terrain, which is very hilly and there are a lot of mountains. As for the legal aspect, there is not much to discuss here, except that the Malaysian Communications and Multimedia Commission is the one in charge of regulating the telcos. As for the Porter's Five Forces analysis, I have found that competition in the industry is very, very high. Unlike other countries, Malaysia has a very high competition between three main telcos, and then the threat of new entrants is moderate. While it may be difficult for new entrants to penetrate the market, once they become serious competitors because of Maxis's pricing. The threat of substitutes is high because there are many telcos offering exactly the same products and services, and the bargaining power of suppliers is high because the same suppliers provide the materials and the products necessary for Maxis to create their network to similar telcos. The bargaining power of customers is low, although the threat of subsidies is high, because because subscribers cannot actually negotiate prices or services. According to the analysis that I've conducted, I found that it's important for Maxis to internally improve. Based on that, I have come up with several implementation strategies. The first is to build a better network coverage and connectivity, and to provide new 5G network service. These will be further compounded and expanded on topic-wise by my colleague Kumar later on. And then I would also like to suggest that Maxis should improve their customer engagement and services, as well as provide training, employee motivation, and ensuring manpower is sufficient to conduct all the services that they are providing. They should also create more targeted marketing strategies, because these are important to engage audiences and create a better market sentiment. Next, I would pass it to my colleague.
A very good afternoon to Ms. Goh and my fellow classmates. I thank Jolene for her presentation earlier. And now I'm going to continue as the production department part. So the main problem statement that I see is that we have lack of coverages, services among rural and urban areas throughout the country. Also, another problem that came up was that the high congestion in Maxis outlets. This is due to, for example, when someone wishes to go just to an outlet just to make a payment, but he or she has to wait in line so long for all others who have other problems, such as the technical issues with their mobile device, online problems, and all that. Also, the lack of customer service care has been an issue for us, and I'd like to address it. So next, objectives that I've come up are to increase the Maxis cellular coverage by building more mobile towers in rural areas with larger land. Also, in like high-density areas like in town and certain prime spots, building a large mobile tower will be hard, as space is a very big factor. So the idea of introducing cellular boost modems or repeaters will help them, as it's a very small device and it just helps rotate and bounce a signal around to create a wider spread for that signal. And to deal with the congestion issues faced by Maxis, the idea to break up the Maxis outlets into two separate identities but in the same location has come up, and these two will be in prime spots. And also the introduction of 5G cellular coverage, which is the fastest internet speed in the nation amongst all other companies. So I've done a SWOT analysis to discuss on the problems that we face and all that, and our strengths and weaknesses. So the first strength we have is we are able to become the number one cellular network provider across the nation. Also, we provide efficient and effective customer service care to those customers, and we can get the 5G network speed and coverage, which is the best in the country. The several weaknesses that we face are the low signal strength in rural areas due to lack of mobile towers, also the high congestion in Maxis service centers, which are a problem, and also the high expectancy by customers, which will lead to disappointment. Next, on opportunities we create, we help ease the burden of customers when they visit a Maxis service center by having a separate function to each center. Also, we can gain better network coverage with the introduction of 5G. And the threats we face are pretty similar from every company, as we have high competition from other cellular companies such as Max, Cellcom, DG, U-Mobile, and also the lack of space in among like the congested urban areas where we can build mobile large tower networks for higher signals. So I'll talk about the operations and also followed by implementation strategies. Firstly, it will be getting better supplies of mobile towers which provide larger frequency network. Also, we find alternatives which, as commented earlier, are the boosters and repeaters, which can spread and bounce the mobile networks in highly congested areas. And also, we create the 5G network, which will be the fastest network up to date for internet speed. And then, having the specific outlets for servicing and repairing of mobile devices. Also, having outlets just for making for payment and registration, which will ease the crowd in Maxis outlets. Also, increasing customer service quality by ensuring all Maxis staff greet and treat customers very well by sending several staff for training programs before starting their work at the customer service desk. And also have on-call technicians, which is very new, which will be located in the main repair stations in KL and Sabah, where only you can go directly to there, and then a technician will see your phone and access and see what's wrong with it, and immediately if it's able to repair on the spot, they'll give it to you back right on the spot without having to wait and go through the problems that you face every other day. And lastly, the implementation strategies will be to allocate a single customer service outlet, as I said earlier, where there are on-call technicians there. And then technicians are able to access and fix any minor issues on your mobile devices and return to the customers immediately. Also, like rural areas, like around eastern Malaysia and further up north, like Perlis and all that, will have just like joint outlets because there are less customers and not waste other opportunities they have there. and also increasing the mobile towers in several rural areas such as Kelantan, Pahang, Terengganu, Perlis, and East Malaysia, where there is a lot of space so that towers can be built easily for better signal strength. And also placing all the mobile boosters and repeaters which I mentioned earlier in highly contested areas such as Penang, KL, and the main town areas. Also allocating several areas in the nation with 5G internet speed by rerouting and tuning the Maxis internet speed among the certain areas so that like right in the core where we need the fastest internet due to the problems, 5G will be there to help us out. So I'd like to pass on my, our group presentation to Vivian. Thank you.
Thank you, Kumar. I would like to talk about Human Resource Department. Human Resource is a company's function that used to develop employees' attitude, knowledge, capability, and managing them to achieve the company's objective. The main problem Maxis Human Resource face is employees' job performances. Many customers complain about employees' job performances after the issue of unfair mobile price plan. In April 2016, it was reported that Texas cheated customers by not offering fair mobile plan to every customer's group. The unethical behavior of Maxis leader caused employees to lose trust, disengage, and disconnect from the company. Studies found that 84% of disengaged employees may reduce quality of delivering tasks, 72% of them will negatively affect the customers. Therefore, Maxis need to improve their employees' engagement to have a better employee job performance. The next problem that Maxis Human Resource need to overcome is high employee turnover. Total employee of Maxis in 2015 was 2,900. However, Maxis lost 500 employees by having only 2,400 employees in 2016. Lee Mayfun, our person in charge of finance department, aims to cut down company costs. Unfortunately, having high employee turnover will increase the cost on hiring. Studies found that recruitment process is the most effective way in reducing employees' turnover. Therefore, Maxis can solve the problem of high employee turnover by improving their recruitment process. The first objective is to improve employee job performances by increasing 10% of employee engagement. The next objective is to reduce employee turnover through improving recruitment efficiency. This table shows SWOT of Maxis Human Resource. The strength of Maxis Human Resource is provide training program, strong online recruitment. The main weaknesses of Maxis Human Resource is poor employee job performances and high employee turnover rate. The opportunities for Maxis is men and unemployed fresh graduates. DG and Cellcom offer higher pay to their employees is considered as the threat of Maxis Human Resource. In order to achieve the first objective of improving employees' engagement, this chart shows that the ratings of employees towards the effectiveness of employees' engagement. The chart shows that the main driving factor of employees' engagement is performance-based reward. 72% of employees rank that rewards given for high-performing employees have significant impact on employees' engagement. Therefore, Maxis is recommended to improve to apply performance-based reward to improve the employees' engagement. In order to achieve the second objective, Maxis hire candidates through online recruitment method. However, the chart shows that employee referral program is considered as the most effective way to hire candidates. 69% of large companies they implement employee referral programs, and 88% of them rated that employee referral is the most successful source of hiring. This table shows a summary on different recruitment channels. Based on the table, large amount of screening is needed when company use online recruitment method. On the other hand, employee referral program can help Maxis to save time because initial screening is done by the employees. Besides, employees referral program, they will create a higher retention rate of employees because referred employees, they will stay in the company more than 5 years. Therefore, Maxis can recruit, can apply employee referral programs to reduce their employees' turnover rate. Next, Jiayi would like to talk about marketing department. Thank you.
Good morning to everyone. I will continue my part with marketing. I will start with problem statement. The problem statements under marketing is the low subscriber compared to their competitors in the recent years, like DG and Cellcom. According to Maxis, they have lost 200 3K mobile subscribers in the recent years. They are also losing market shares in their mobile sectors. They are using bad segmentation to base their engagement on. They are not aware of the individualized offers did not reach the right customers. They are also proof that the marketing strategies are ineffective because of their customer dissatisfaction is a lot of complaint and maybe the competitors coming out a lot of offerings. So the objective of marketing department is to retain the customer and to gain 20% more new subscribers in West Malaysia and to increase the brand awareness of Maxis. Based on the table, you can see that Maxis has losing their paying powers in year 2015 from 35.6% to year 2016, 33.6%. And the BCG metrics is used to analyze the used as an analytical tool to help Maxis to achieving their marketing objective. You can see that three main competitors in the telecommunications industry is all under cash cows, which is a low growth and high market share. So in order to compete with them in these segments, Maxis should create their own competitive advantage over others, like increase their good reputations, because increase their good reputations will increase their corporate worth and also provide their sustained competitive advantage. So about the SWOT analysis, the SWOT analysis for marketing departments is their strength is on their good deals and special offers for different age groups, like if their target on age group below 25 years old and above 35 years old, which is businessmen. They are also provide reasonable plans and packages like business, like Maxis One Business and Maxis One Plan that can sublines for others. They are also having weaknesses like poor network planning, lack of coverage, lack of Maxis centers, and plan is too expensive, and the reputation is not good because of the customer dissatisfaction. Their opportunity is their new telecommunication gadgets, new advanced 5G plans, their growth of people who are using smartphones and internet service. They are also building more Maxis centers. The threat is on the rapid technology changes and the global economic slowdown, market share decrease, and new competitors come into the market. So about the implementation strategies, I would recommend Maxis to use market segmentations on psychographic segmentation because it's identified the potential consumers' lifestyles, like everyone must live with smartphone and internet service. They are also can target on income other than age group. Income segments like low income segments, they can provide a low price package for customers or maybe the given discounts for them. Marketing mix strategies like product strategy, they can expand their product line by cooperating with more smartphone manufacturers to produce a low-cost smartphone. They can also implement 5G plans in order to increase their coverage and also increase the speed of the network. Their packaging can be special and eco-friendly. Second, they can also use place strategies by building more specific centers in order to increase their distribution channels. They can separate into two outlets, which is registrations and customer service. Their pricing strategy can use price penetration strategy. It is to lower their price in order to increase their market share. Psychological strategy is like the smartphone that its market price is at 1,500. They can price their products in 1,499 in order to let the customer know that their products is cheaper than others. About the royalty program, they can give reward to their royal customers by giving high allocations of data by giving the same price. For the promotion strategies, they can use online or maybe offline advertising. Online advertising is like advertise online on social media or maybe Facebook, Twitter, or maybe Instagram to implement their new 5G plan. And offline advertising, they can put their advertise on billboards or maybe beside bus stand or maybe banner to attract. It will be easily to attract the people who pass by and maybe driver who stuck in the traffic. So sponsorship, businesses can get their sponsorship from the higher profile company in order to let many people see their products. So they can also participate themselves in telecommunications fair. They must ensure that their workers is well trained to promoting their products. And lastly, is word of mouth. It's very important because like one satisfied customers can bring 10 more customers into masses, and one dissatisfied customers can take away 10 more customers from masses. So that's all for my presentations. I will pass it to Mayfern to continue with her part.
Thanks, Vivian. Now, I would like to talk about the finance problems. Okay, according to Alexander, Mrs. Berhad lost 149 cases of travel in 2016. And then this showed the many users of company had left in last year. It could be linked to mobile internet users based on was dropping from 9 million in the third quarter of 2015 to 8.5 million. And then it shows the revenue from the prepaid and the postpaid service fell 2.5% and 1.7% to RM 1.2 million and 994 million in 2016. It shows the high competitors in this market. Next, so as a finance leader, we need to set up some objectives in order to achieve in next years. For the first objective, increase the 10% of market share in 2020, and then increase the 5% of revenue to measure the customer value in 2017. And it also increased the more than 12 of subscribers in 2017. And the lastly, we also analyze to the forecast of new investment in order to make sure increase more than 8% of revenue after 2020. Next, I would like to talk about the SWOT analysis of Messi's company. For the strengths, Messi is a cost leader in the market, as Messi are available to provide one ringgit package with the free smartphone, whereby the other telecommunication will not provide this package. And the message also record its quarter four in 2016 sales revenue with the rules of 7.7 from 468 million to 504 million. And then for the weakness, frustrations of current ratio and yearly company profit are after tax. The debt equity ratio increased while it affects the return on investment of Messi's. And then for the opportunity, Messi's Berhad could open for tender to cooperate with outside supplier or investor for the new plan. This cooperation tax could help Messi's to reduce the turnover, and it may benefit to both parties who involved in that new plans. And then for the financial approval of be the first to bring in Messi's 5G for increase the market share, it also important for the Messi's finance departments. And then the lastly, the train on development of skilled workers with my help Messi's to reduce cost to higher skilled labor that will include the high investment. For the trend, Malaysia economy's downturn had led some subscribers downgrade or unable to afford high price plan. This rapid changing of the new technology such as the new types of coverage tower. And then the other service provider will introduce more competitive, more mobile plans to attract more customers. So they have some strategy for finance department. First, Messi's need may seek investor or supplier on building more towers. This because the telecommunications This is because the telecom Malaysia fixed line networks profit cover most of the Malaysia. According to rumor, TT.com will invest this type of project within these few years. So this is the opportunity for Maxis to in order to increase the number of investors in this project. And then through this method, Maxis also can use return on investment to estimate this project. These are the return ROI. The table show estimate of ROI is 16.15%. It means the efficiency of the company investment is more efficiency and more affordable. Because according to others research, it means the high efficiency increase the high profitability in this investor. Next, a finance leader of Maxis Berhad could allocate an amount of budget to introduce 5G networks. This is because, as mentioned above, Malaysian people is looking for the faster internet speed despite of the cost of money payment. So company could cooperate with Samsung Malaysia bring in a new technology. This because Samsung is the one of the developments for this technology, and then Maxis do not need to invest a huge amount of monies which may affect this daily productions. This table shows the mobile plan for each company. So our new plans is RMs 130x with the 5G users. Next, this one is the estimate of expenses for production, Kumar's. And then for the lastly, for as the financial department, we also providing internal training and mentoring is a key to reducing the cost. Supervisors should cross-training all the employees in each department. So as the financial leaders, we can recommend the HR department to provide the internal training and mentoring to across training all employees. This can reduce the program developments and some training in order to reduce the cost. And then the table also will provide the HR department for the salary, estimation of salary. And then for the next is the estimation of expenses for marketing. The advertisements will estimate for 10,000, then telecommunication fare will 5,000. So I will end my slide. Thanks.